Welcome back to Poker Night. I've got a fun 7-card game for you that I'm going to show you how to play. I've seen this played in like 2-3 different ways. I'm going to show you how we play it, which I think is the most fun way and variation to play 7-card Screw Your Neighbor. Here's how you play and deal 7-card Screw Your Neighbor. Start with a shuffled deck. Determine your ante. You can go with a little smaller ante on this game because there's going to be a lot of betting the way I play it. Each chip is worth a quarter, and the ante is going to be a quarter. Once your ante is good, you're going to deal all players 7 down cards. And they can pick them up, look at them, rearrange them, do whatever they want with them. Now, I've seen this game played with like 3 different variations. And the variation I'm going to show you, I think, is probably the funnest way to play it. It brings the biggest pot, and it's, in my opinion, it's the most fun. So let's take a look at player 1 cards, and we got player 2 over here. Let's take a look and see what he has, and let's take a look and see what the dealer has. So I do a betting round just going left of dealer clockwise around the table. This player here, let's say he's just going to bet a quarter and the table is going to call. So now all players need to determine what 3 cards they want to pass to their neighbor, or what 3 cards they want to kind of screw their neighbor with. So just make sure that when you pass the cards, that the player you're passing to does not look at them before he discards. So this player here pass these 3. And the dealer, so he'll pass these 3. So now everyone's got their passed cards. Everyone should have 7 cards again. And you can rearrange them however you want to. So right now the dealer is going to say 1, 2, 3 flip. And everyone's going to turn over 1 card at a time. And betting action from here on out is going to go high card on the table. Dealer's got a 10. Dealer bet a quarter. And table will call. Once the pot's good, everyone can flip up their 2nd card. Dealer's showing a pair of 10s. He'll bet a quarter and everybody will call. Pot's good. Dealer says 1, 2, 3 flip, revealing the 3rd card. Now this is where there's a little bit of strategy involved in how you turn up your cards. You can hold the cards in your hand and flip them out as you want, or you can just rearrange them and flip them from a stack. But this player here, he may be bluffing someone out with throwing out the 3 diamonds. Maybe the dealer is trying to do some bluffing, not sure, with throwing up the pair of 10s. But while holding all 7 cards, you can do a lot more bluffing than a variation where you throw 2 cards away and you hold the 5. So the dealer's gonna bet and everybody's gonna call. 1, 2, 3 flip. And everyone reveals their 4th card. So we got 4, 5, 6 over here. Dealer's still got the 10s and he's gonna bet that quarter. Everybody will call. Pot's good. 1, 2, 3 flip. Everybody turns over their 5th card. So we got 3, 4, 5, 6 over here. So table's probably starting to worry a little bit. This guy over here, he's got a pair of 7s. 7, 8, 9. Dealer's starting to look not too good. But he's still tall better, so he'll bet a quarter. And everybody will call. Pot's good. 1, 2, 3 flip. Everyone turns over their 6th card. This player here, he's got 3 7s showing. Dealer's holding a 7, so we know that he doesn't have 4 7s, but easily could have a boat. This player over here has got a pair of 6s showing. 3, 4, 5, 6, pair of 6s. And dealer has the pair of 10s, but this player here, he's going to bet those 3 7s. He's going to bet a quarter. Everybody's going to call. Now everyone could turn up their 7th and final card. and determine what their best five card hand is. This player here, he's got 3 sevens, 2 eights. He's got a full boat. So we'll see how he snuck it in there at last. No one really kind of knew what he had till that last card fell. This player here, he's got sixes and threes. And dealer, looks like all he has is the tens. This player here wins with the full boat. Nice big healthy stack. The way that I play it, this game brings some pretty big pots. And it's a lot of fun with holding the seven cards and doing it this way. Let's take this game to your next poker night. Play it with your poker friends. See how they like it. Comment down below. And thanks for watching.